Somebody will see it when they walk past.
So, basic tenets of training, adrenaline up, learning down. So, we're gonna take some time to work with the idea of, if you cannot do things together around us, if you cannot effectively do things together, so we're gonna go in, we're in a station, we're gonna do a few things on the station, we'll move to another station, he'll stay, you'll go pet sheep. Okay. And if you can't do that, then we'll work on that. And then we'll use our directions. We're gonna take you around for a while. That's how we find for the sheep to also understand that you are well controlled the dog.
Okay.
We can do as much positive reinforcement training as we want to, and herding will never be 100% positive because it's not ever going to be fun for you. So we have to make sure that it's fair. They can set it down because you are going to control the dog. Good. So just get him to turn. And at the same time, because I'm all about throwing people over the deep end, that black ewe right in front of you,
yeah.
If you don't pay attention to her, she will come up and punch your dog.
Okay.
And she will punch him with a hook. So you have to start at this point immediately practicing watching your lifestyle.
Okay.
And if he can't seem to figure out how to do that, put your leg right next to his chin and just walk his chin around. There you go. And that's still a spin, if he finishes it. Yeah. But it means you don't have to talk a lot enough. And then whatever your other direction is, if your leg is up next to him, then his front feet turn while they're still on the toe. There you go. And then he can walk off into the air and wonder what the heck just happened. Good. Now, I want you to have him walk with you on your left side, but hugging the perimeter so he's on the wall side, and you're going to go around to the next tub.
It's funny how they advance every time his back is turned.
Yeah, it's that whole, there's this whole theory about advance and retreat in predator-prey situations that gets used a lot in manipulating training. Good, and then forward to the next one. Outside of the person. But his tail makes it so big or steady that he looks like he's not going to do it correctly before he blows. not. I have no idea. So, and I want you to go 3/4 of the way around so you'll end up on this. If he is comfortable, then you're going to walk inside the tub and leave him on the outside. Funny how off the right side he's like, blah, 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 and off the left side he's like, I could have killed him before they killed him. Stress behaviors are. There's the tail wagging, there's the jumping, there's the panting. But at least he is breathing as opposed to holding his jaw really, really tight, like, oh, we're all coming back. You know? So that's good. But what that means is we definitely need him feeling safer among this group of sheep. They obviously are not feeling too worried about you guys as a head because their eyes are kind of half closed and they're not trying to climb the walls. So that's good. One of the big reasons we use these tubs is to teach a dog that has a home-based safe place to how to feel. So that if anything goes haywire, you'll be able to say tub, or he can go to the tub to let you know he's had too much.
Okay.
As opposed to leaving you alone with a bunch of sheep in the middle of the field and a thunderstorm rolling in.
Yeah!
Kind of thing. So... that I find that it gives them a way to communicate that. Get used to telling them, no, I won't take this jumping up behavior in the ring, and I won't take this other behavior in the ring, but here's a thing you can do together, and they use it to say I've had too much. And you can respect that, so once you move out to a bigger place where there aren't, you know, convenient tubs hanging out like TARDISes around the world. Then they still know that they can trust you to understand when they've had too much. I find that it's for the dogs that are too much and are really slash and burn, it gives them a place where they know they're not going to get in trouble. So it works for all kinds of reasons, but it helps build confidence and a more quiet confidence. So I like getting started this way with anybody who's been off for a while, or even dogs that have been in training, but you want to work on their holds. Good. So let's go all the way around in the away direction again. And you think about taking the inside track on the tubs and letting him have a little more leash if he's as relaxed as he was the first time going around. Otherwise, he'll miss the scoop and split. Got it. Stand in place. You can feel where he is, right?
Yeah.
to cut in front of the shoulder and this outside foot to tap back feet and keep a couple steps back. Like, what did you just do on the movie? Then you say good job.
Okay, so we're just trying to get him to back.
And then you say easy again and then
go forward.
Okay.
Stop and move out of the way because you have a dog.
So go up to the next panel and you'll say back and you'll do the same thing again.
Okay.
And then you'll praise him when he goes away. And after we do. Here, so that you've got hands on either side, and then you're dashing into the middle. And he says, "Oh crap, no!" Right? So this is how you know he's worried, not that he just wants to eat sheep. He's
sure.
Worried, and he wants to eat them before they eat him. And then I'm keeping an eye on. Okay, you're proper there. You're going to have him come live in that stress just a little bit, and you're going to stay completely calm and collected like I do this every day. It's the classic fake it till you make it.
Okay.
And I'm going to climb out. Steps. switch to stand in front of him. And this is, you're absolutely right, this is not a fight, so you don't have to stare him down. Because that's not what it, then there's more stress. I'm trying to lower the stress of what is obviously for him. But no, we don't do this type of situation. If I were going to blast into them, I would blast into them and blast through and probably grab one and then it would be done. Thank you.